Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. Today, our discussion is on heat capacity. We shall learn about the definition of heat capacity and its calculation. Have you ever tried noodle soup and stirred noodle before? What is their difference? A noodle soup consists of noodles in a bowl of soup, but in a stirred noodle, all the water is removed before it is served. If you go to a restaurant and you are in a great hurry, will you order a noodle soup or a stirred noodle? I think you will order a stirred noodle because it will be cooled to edible temperature more quickly. A noodle soup, however, will remain hot for a longer time, and this is no good if you are in a great hurry. The reason for them to have different cooling time is that they have absorbed different amounts of heat when they are cooked. The noodle soup consists of a lot of water and it will absorb more energy to reach the highest temperature. Therefore, it will take a longer time to be cooled. Now, let's say when the temperature of the noodle soup falls by 20 degrees Celsius and it releases, say, 10,000 joules of energy. Under the same condition, the stirred noodle will release only, say, 1,000 joules of energy. In this example, the noodle soup absorbs more internal energy than the stirred noodle when they are raised by the same temperature. In physics, we say that the noodle soup has a higher heat capacity than the stirred noodle. Now, let's define heat capacity as follows. Heat capacity of an object is the energy required to raise the temperature of the object through 1 degree Celsius. In the above example, the noodle soup required 10,000 joules of energy to raise the temperature by 20 degrees Celsius. Therefore, the energy required to raise the noodle soup by 1 degree Celsius is 10,000 joules divided by 20, and the result is 500 joules. That is, the heat capacity of the noodle soup is 500 joules per degree Celsius. Similarly, the heat capacity for the stirred noodle is calculated by dividing 1,000 joules by 20 degrees Celsius, and the result is 50 joules per degree Celsius. The heat capacity of the stirred noodle is only 1/10 that of the noodle soup. Mathematically, heat capacity is represented by capital letter C. It is calculated by dividing the heat transfer Q by the change in temperature delta T. It is written as C equal to Q over delta T. The unit of heat capacity is joule per degree Celsius. For example, the heat capacity of the noodle soup above is 500 joule per degree Celsius, and that of the stirred noodle is 50 joule per degree Celsius. Now, let's look at some examples. Consider a cup of water. Suppose it requires 10,000 joules of energy to raise the temperature from 20 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. Find the heat capacity of the cup. The energy transferred Q is 10,000 joules. The change in temperature delta T is 100 minus 20 equal to 80 degrees Celsius. The heat capacity of the cup of water is therefore C equal to 10,000 divided by 80, and the result is 125 joules per degree Celsius. Now let's look at another example. Consider a block of iron. Given that the heat capacity of the iron block is 200 joules per degree Celsius, how much energy is required to raise the temperature by 30 degrees Celsius? From the equation C equal to Q over delta T, we have Q equal to C times delta T. Since C equal to 200 joules per degree Celsius and delta T is 30 degrees Celsius, the energy required is Q equal to 200 times 30 equal to 6,000 joules. Now please note that heat capacity refers to an object. It depends on the amount of substance as well as the material. The heat capacity of a cup of water is much less than the water in a swimming pool because the swimming pool has much more water. On the other hand, heat capacity depends on material. Consider a piece of stone and a cup of water. Suppose they have the same mass, their heat capacity are not the same because water will absorb more energy than other substances. Heat capacity is usually found by doing an experiment. We shall talk about this in the next video. I hope this video can help you understand more about heat capacity. Thank you for watching.